Like everything else in New York City, the airspace 1,000 feet over the Hudson River is very crowded. And it's up to pilots, not air traffic controllers, to see and avoid running into another aircraft. It may sound like the Wild West, but over the years, the system worked well. Until August 8, 2009, when a helicopter carrying some sightseers collided with a small single-engine airplane right over the river. 9 people died in the crash. Wouldn't it be nice if aircraft were smart enough to help pilots avoid trouble? The answer might very well be here. They may look like toys, but these small helicopters can fly safely and avoid a collision on their own.
What we're interested in is developing automated collision avoidance algorithms that can be used for civilian aircraft in the air traffic control system.
Electrical engineer Claire Tomlin and her students are testing the idea without using expensive aircraft, runways, and control towers. Their key research tools are these modest quad rotors, also known as StarMacs.
We built it with these light carbon fiber tubing and these plastic tube straps, which are good, you know, it's like Lego putting things together quickly.
Tomlin's earlier work at NASA involved a lot of expensive equipment. So as a Stanford and now Berkeley professor,
we built our own platform, which is stable, robust. You can fix it in about 10 minutes if it crashes. And we designed our own printed circuit board. So basically the brains of the vehicle are a couple of computers on board a circuit board that we designed ourselves.
Most helicopters will have fairly complicated mechanisms for tilting the main rotor itself to fly. The way we control StarMac is you actually spin just one of the motors up and one of the motors down, so that allows for a lot simpler control mechanism than with actual helicopters.
Tomlin used a career award from the National Science Foundation to create the first of these aircraft. There's been a lot of trial and error. Now on version 4, tests are done inside the lab or outdoors. Many of the discoveries made here can be adapted for use in civilian and military aircraft. Vehicles may differ a lot in size, but the scientific principles involved in collision avoidance are the same.
Climb.
In this test, students controlling the aircraft try to get them to crash into each other. But the collision avoidance program, based on so-called reachable set technology, kicks in and creates a no-fly zone.
As soon as the vehicles detected that they were coming close to each other's no-fly zones, the automated algorithm on board would take over and would say, no, you can't do that, and it would safely guide the vehicles along kind of the boundaries of these sets.
Research here goes beyond improving air traffic control. For instance, robots like these could also be valuable searching for lost skiers in an avalanche. For this test, the researchers used off-the-shelf rescue beacons, the same devices now used by backcountry skiers. While one helicopter sent out a distress call, the others receiving the signal communicated with each other to quickly find their stranded counterpart.
And so what you see on the left is all of the blue dots is where he thinks the victim could be. And so as you see, as they're flying around and taking measurements, where the victim could be reduces into this small area, which is about 5 centimeters. And so this only took a couple minutes before he had the victim localized.
In this test, the choppers have been programmed to navigate around several obstacles.
We told the quadrotor where the obstacles were, and then it planned the path through the environment to avoid all the obstacles, and then it flew the path.
But to be of the most value to humans, say in navigating narrow or dangerous places, these bots must have the tools to make those decisions on their own. Adding cameras and other sensors make that possible.
The vehicle will look out and sort of see whether or not there are obstacles in its path, whether or not there are other vehicles, whether or not there's something interesting that it should get closer to track.
As the skies get busier and more unmanned vehicles join the traffic flow as well, building airplanes and helicopters that are smart enough to navigate safely on their own is a high calling indeed.
It's a lot of fun to work on. Frustrating at times, but then very rewarding at times.
And maybe one day the reward might be measured in crashes avoided and lives saved. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.